Session. Please join me on every Thursday between 2 p.m. and 3 p.m. on Faith Television, Channel Sky 589. You know, the Lord is sending us to this generation to speak about the coming back of our Lord Jesus Christ. These messages have been changing life, bringing people closer to God, bring understanding to the heart of people. Be part of this program, and I believe you shall be blessed.
Wonderful story of love. The love of our Lord Jesus Christ towards men. He died on the cross of Calvary in order for man to live eternally. By this time last week, we are talking about the birth of our Lord Jesus Christ. The reason why he came is to save man. And we appreciate God for his work, for his deed towards men, for the kind of redemption he gives to us, reformation. He brought us back to his faithfulness, to his holiness. If there's anything to celebrate God over, it should be, that alone, that God save you, save me, brings you out of the mouth of lion, which is devil, to tear to pieces, to destroy. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And it shall be well with someone that is watching today in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Because that's the only reason we came, to acclaim the fact that Jesus Christ come to die for every humanity. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Today shall be glorious.
Amen.
In power, in might.
Amen.
In the faithfulness of the Lord to somebody in the house.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And this International Christian Association, as you have it on the screen, to people who have been part of us, we don't tell you it is not a church program, but a ministry brought out for man to realize that the kingdom of God is real, that Jesus is coming back the second time, to go and tell people that, yes, while expecting the kingdom of God, while walking towards, the kingdom of God, clamoring for it, shouting about it, pray for it. Jesus Christ said, go and tell my people there are some unique things needed for man to really achieve that kingdom. You cannot eat your cake and have it. Whatever you do matters, for this kingdom to be sure. That is the message we are bringing at this time. That's the reason why we come. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And if you want to know more about, how far we have gone on this same matter, visit our YouTube, search for Prophet Olotu. You will find everything there by the grace of God. And every other thing you want to know about this platform will be known to us as this program goes by. You see them on the screen. But virtually, you want to know more about International Christian Association, our mobiles on the phone, you can phone. It's all about talking about the gospel of our Lord Jesus, or a diluted message of the Lord for everyone. This message are not meant for Christians alone. They are for both Muslims, the unbelievers, those who thought they don't have God. My own God is sun, is moon, is water. The message is for all of us. But venture, there is someone somewhere who needs to be caught up with the mind of the Lord, with the message of the Lord for the eternity. maybe it is time for someone to realize that what he's doing, oh, is not acceptable to God. That is the reason why this message is not meant for those in church alone, for people in the mosque alone, and for those who are atheists, those who are believers, you know, who have their own gods made by man, who has mouth but they cannot speak, they have eyes, they cannot talk. But God who have eyes, he says, who form eyes will not be able to see. Bring out this message at this time. And it shall be well with you as you listen today in Jesus' name.
Amen.
We are going to beckon to someone to join us on Faith World TV, Channel Sky 589, you know, and see what God is bringing to us. Even as we haven't just one day left, if not even up to one day anymore, for us to cross over to the year 2021. And it shall be well with you as you do so. I pray for someone today that shall be well with your soul in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Calamity will not befall you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You will not cry, you will not weep.
Amen.
The Lord will lift you up. He will take you to the year coming.
Amen.
Faithfully. In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Power to forge ahead, receive it in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Power to be who you want to be in the name of God, receive it in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I say it again, you will not fall.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Evil will not befall you.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Cry will not be your portion.
Amen.
That's anywhere you are crying at this moment, may the Lord wipe away your tears in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Where anywhere there is sickness in your being, in your body, may the Lord God meet with you there and touch you and heal you in the name of Jesus
Amen.
Christ. Healing is coming over you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
You see that anointing of healing all around your life in the name of Jesus
Amen.
Christ. Everything that is looking impossible, you'll be crying over it, you'll be praying over it. Let a possibility be deleted from your life now over it in the name
Amen.
Of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Receive your miracle.
Amen.
And go and share your miracle.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus
Amen.
Christ. I pray this prayer for someone that is watching. You will know God more.
Amen.
More than this year.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You will serve him in faithfulness.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus
Amen.
Christ. And his name shall be glorified.
Amen.
Lord Jesus, we commit this program to your hands today. Come and have your way.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus Christ,
Amen.
Everyone that will hear you today, Lord, let them understand your word and your will
Amen.
For mankind in the name of Jesus
Amen.
Christ. We that you want to use here today, fill us to the maximum
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And your name alone shall be exalted.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
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 My name is Prophet Stimulari Lotu. And the same man of God will be coming. We are here together. The person, evangelist, Raphael Omotayo Adiboye, God bless you, sir.
Amen. You
for another glorious and wonderful time before the Lord. You know, the Bible made us to know that nobody receives anything except it's given from above. That's the reason why we are here. And we have come, and we are coming indeed, and we are here. And may the Lord help each and every one of us and the listeners in the mighty name of Jesus
Amen.
Christ.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
This God is my God.
Yes.
Forever and ever. He will be my God. Now until the end. This God is your God, if you know that. Forever and ever. Because he created heaven and earth. He will be your guide. Now until the end. And this God is your God. And forever and ever, it will remain the God. Now to the Lord is the one who brought you to the year 2020. Even to those who believe that nature is the best God, there are scientists that says, "Oh, there's no God somewhere." Hallelujah.
Amen.
Yes, everybody must cling to what they believe in. and begin to talk about it. You that believe that there is God Almighty, begin to talk about God. You don't need to fight anyone. No. Begin to talk about that God that you know. Mm. Hallelujah.
Mm.
Amen. Talk Amen. About what you know.
Mm.
And let everyone begin to talk about what they know.
Mm.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
If your own God is the most powerful, he knows what to change man to himself. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He brought you to 2020, and 2020 is gone. Hallelujah.
Amen.
It has come to the last bus stop today. And everyone is now looking forward to another year called 2021. It's our song now. By the power in the name of Jesus Christ, you will see that year.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
What is it that God is having for us today? Because this God is our eyes, we used to see. It's our leg, we used to walk. And it's the key that we used to open every doors. That's why we love him. What is it that is having for us again today? As we are entering into another year, God to speak to his people. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He says, you know, the school of life, we'll be talking about this for a while. The school of life, where God put us in the beginning, in the Garden of Eden, that we lost sheeply to the hands of Satan, a deceiver. You know, a deceiver. And by the mercy of God, he brought it back to us through Jesus Christ. And he wants us to maintain, you know, this status quo with him, to walk with him, to serve him. Because there's a place coming after now, which is the kingdom of God. Kingdom of God will come one day. That kingdom of God will sack every work we do here. Our assignment here, service on earth here. Before we go to him, before we leave this place. But Jesus Christ wants us to go and hammer this message that he's coming back. Yeah. And his coming back is to come and judge our hard work. We spoke about it about 2 weeks ago, even last week. Say, yes, you know, there is no law, no gospel, no gospel, no judgment. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And what is it that God is giving to us again today is all about even in the land. Oh. You know, by this time last year, God was talking about pandemic that we see ravaging in our land now. Despite that, some people were saying, well, God doesn't know anything about it. But I'm sure that, yeah, God spoke about it before we began to see it happen in our lands. And throughout, you know, this year, the Lord began to talk about things that we are still seeing happen about the pandemic. You can still remember months back, God said there will be so many phases of it. The reason why God allowed it to happen, God allowed it, nothing happened except the Lord knows about it. Even when man wants to do it, if God don't want it to happen, he knows what to do. But God said he allowed it to beat us because of what we are doing. He says, man are doing their own thing, sinning every day against his will. He said, because man will not change, he will allow so many phases of it. And we thought it was a joke then. God said it's going to batter the economy of the world. We thought it was joking then. And God said, a time will come that we will change the name, the title given to the pandemic. We see everything happen. We will come up with so many things. And it's not that God doesn't appreciate what the government or the land is doing, but God is saying to us that if they networking, you know, assignment together. Because the Bible says there's no leadership without God. So we are not saying all our leaders all over the world, they are not of the Lord. But God is saying when he wants to have his own way in their governments, he knows what to do. But what is that God is saying again the next year coming? God is speaking. He said there will be this pandemic will still move, will still work. God said he's not stopping it yet. He said he wants to bring man to their knees. He wants them to know that it's God who created them, me and you. He said, but whoever, he said, a time will come that everybody will be to look for Jesus Christ. And God said, in the year coming, there will be more gospel in the land, evangelism in the land, all over the world. Go and note it. Say, God says he wants to raise more gospel, more gospelers, evangelism in the land. It will be increased more than this year. There will be so many people in the street talking about God. Next year coming. Hallelujah.
Amen.
God says so many things will come to an end next year among his people, among the nations of the world. Hallelujah. So expect more of this pandemic in the year 2021. It is not that all those vaccines that you are expecting will not work, but even when you think it will work, that might not make God to take it away from our land. But he wants us to be talking about forgiveness from the Lord, asking for forgiveness. God is now expecting redemption of his people. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So that all of us can come to the will of the Lord. And he wants us to know at this time that the gospel that is coming at this time is not about nationalities alone. When God is talking about evil, he's talking about immorals, wickedness, bad things in the land. And God said, evil in the land is increasing every day. And that is why he's not happy about man. That is why I want to chastise man. Hallelujah. And the gospel that is coming, that he wants us to go and talk about, he wants people to talk about, at this time, you gospelers, is not in nationalities alone. It's not about color alone. When somebody is talking, it's not about color. It's not about size. It's not about nationality. It's not about who he is or where he comes from. It's about the gospel of God who created both heaven and earth. Even when you don't believe in him, he wants me and you to know that he is God by himself. Nobody changes him. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He wants us to know that he is God. He can speak for himself. That is the reason why we have come at this time. That God said there is evil in the land. Unless we decrease the evil we perpetrate into the world he created, evil will not stop in the land. That is what he's saying. Hallelujah.
Amen.
There are so many, like I said earlier on, there are so many things we believe in. You are an engineer, you believe in your own, you know, your engineering work. You are a medical doctor, you believe in your medical, you know, practices. You are a businessman, you know what to transact. So I am a gospeler too, a prophet of God. I should be able to talk about what I know about it. Hallelujah.
Amen.
No, God is talking about people bringing laws to the land. That they don't want to hear more about God. See, that is when he wants to increase the volume more. Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 So we are not meant to fear telling people what God is saying. As a gospeler, God said there is increase in the evil he doesn't want in the land day by day, in our conduct, in what we love to do. Except we repent from those evil. Evil will not decrease in the land. We don't want to destroy ourselves. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But what does the Bible say, sir? Luke chapter 19. Let's see what verse 8 to 14 says.
Then Zacchaeus stood and said to the Lord.
Yes.
Look, Lord.
Look, Lord.
I give half of my goods.
You know, this young man, he heard about Jesus Christ. And he wanted to know him. While Jesus was passing by, he ran to the top of the tree. And Jesus Christ saw him. He knew his heart. He knows what was going on in his heart. This guy wanted to know me. He said, come down. That was why he started to talk to Jesus Christ. What does he say, sir?
I give half of my goods to the poor.
I give all that I have to the poor.
And I have
Everything I've taken from people unrightly, wickedness that I've imparted into the people's heart, into their life, Lord, I repent from day to day. Lord, I release myself unto you. That is what God wanted from us at this time. Everyone, you know what you have done. You have rid people of their glory, their blessings, and he wants to do as this man has done. What does he say, sir?
And if I have taken anything from anyone,
if there's anything I have taken wrongly from people,
By false accusation.
I restore them back.
Fourfold.
In fourfold, Lord, I release them back. Even when I cannot see them anymore, people have duped. You know, all scammers, you scam people. You can come back to God and say, I am sorry. Even when you cannot give back those things you've taken, you might not even know those people anymore. You might have killed so many in the course of taking what belongs to them. But what God wanted from you today, for me today, is to come back to you and say, Lord, I am sorry. I leave everything unto you. God knows what to do to buy you to himself. What does he say, sir? He
says, and Jesus said to him,
Today,
salvation has come to your household. Because you release yourself to me.
You come out of your evil way. Today, salvation. If you are one of those who have not given everything about you to God, you have not released your evil unto God. Say, God, I know I've done evil before. I'm no more going to do it. Salvation will not come to you. Salvation is about leaving evil unto good. God said, there is evil in the land. Not even one. Many of it. But somebody who have done it before met with the Lord Jesus Christ. He released everything. Are you one of those who is still wallowing in sin, in trouble, in wickedness, in evil, in immorals? The year that is coming is going to sack so many people. It's going to visit so many people. God said he wants to beat so many people with his rod next year, 2021. So don't expect best in the year coming, except you come to God in your own household and let God say what he's saying to Zacchaeus, that salvation will come to your house. And when salvation comes to your house, evil will stop there. Hallelujah. Mm. When salvation comes to your country where you are a president, evil will stop there. Mm. If all of us allow evil to cease in the land, then salvation will come to the land. Hallelujah. People are dying. God is not going to stop it. I know some people say, what's he talking about? That is what God is saying. Hallelujah.
Amen.
What does he say, sir? He says something further.
For the Son of Man. Has come to seek.
And to save.
That which was lost.
God sent Jesus Christ to come and save the lost one. People that are off the track of the Lord. Who doesn't want to do the will of God? Jesus Christ came because of them, because of you. Who believe there is no God, there is God, and there is going to be judgment at the last day. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You don't need to kill all the gospelers because you don't want to hear their voice. If you don't want to hear their voice, just close your ears and begin to, you know, follow your own business you are doing. And let people that want to hear it. Hallelujah.
Amen.
God said there is evil in the land. And fortunately and unfortunately, the evil that is happening in the land is affecting the rulers of the land.
Everyone.
If you are president, the evil in the land is affecting your governance. You are a king, it's affecting your rulership. You are a director in the office, it's affecting you. So why don't you allow people to talk about the evil on the land and let God be glorified. Hallelujah.
Amen.
There are evil that is making God unhappy in the land, says the Almighty God. Hallelujah. You are a child, you don't want to hear what your parents are saying. It's evil in the land.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because the Lord, you say, oh, hear what your parents are saying to you. The corrections of the elders. In the right way, anyway, not the wrong way. What does he say for that, sir? Say something.
Now, as they heard this thing, he spoke another parable. Because it was near Jerusalem, and because they thought the kingdom of God will appear immediately.
Yes.
Therefore, he said,
they thought the kingdom of God will appear immediately. That was why many don't believe in God. You know, people have been saying, Jesus Christ will come since how many years ago, how many years passed. What does he say to them? Yes, sir.
Therefore, he said, a certain noble man went into a far country to receive himself a kingdom and to return. So he called
that's
10 of his servants.
That's okay, sir. I don't want us to, you know, I just want us to see that Jesus Christ said something in that place, occupy it till I come. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He said, occupy till I come, which is the assignment he gave to the gospelers. Say, go and occupy till I come, which means go and talk about me till I come back. Everything I reveal to you, everything you know about me. Like I said, everyone, you know, whatever you know about automobile, that is what you talk about. That's your business, that's your knowledge, that is what you tell people. He told his own people too. The servant too, go and occupy till I come back. Me, go and tell people what I want till I come back. Evil is in the land. The land starts from your household, from your offices. What you carry out, what I carry out, what I do, what you do, that is not priestly to God. Sir, what does he say in Luke 24, verse 44 to 53. What does he say quickly? The Lord doesn't want us to perish. What does he say, sir?
Then he said to them, these are the words which I spoke to you while I was with you.
These are the things I spoke to you while I was with you.
That all things must be fulfilled.
That all things must be fulfilled.
Which were written in the law of Moses.
Everything that was written in the law of Moses before I came, they were the word of God.
And the prophets.
Even there are so many preachers today, we'll be saying this on this program. When it comes to the law of Moses, the way they talk of the law of Moses is as if it was not the word of God. Jesus Christ was the one who spoke it here again. That everything he said to his people then, they were his word. To direct, to control us, to chastise us. The law he gave to Moses was about us. It was about Jesus Christ coming. What does he say for that, sir?
And the prophets.
And the prophets.
And the psalms.
And the psalms.
Concerning me.
Concerning Jesus Christ coming to teach us what God really wanted. Because we have moved away from the laws of the law. What does he say, sir?
And he opened the understanding.
He opened their understanding.
Their understanding that
how I wish your understanding about God will be open more than before today, before you enter into the year coming.
That they might comprehend the scriptures.
That you might know that the scriptures of God.
Then he said to them,
that you, pastor, might know, president, you might know, prime minister, you might know, king, you might know, queen, you might know, whatever might be your position, father, mother, you might know, brother, sister, you might know, that the word of God is God himself. A day of judgment will sack every one of us. Mm-hmm. Doesn't matter how many you kill here, you think, it doesn't matter to you. If you don't change, if I don't change for that evil, God is coming to chastise. To chastise every evil that man is going to do. What does he say to us, sir?
Understanding that they might comprehend the scriptures.
Yes.
Then he said to them.
He said to them.
Thus it is written.
Yes.
And thus it was necessary for the Christ to suffer. And to rise.
Yes.
From the dead the third day.
Yes.
And that repentance and remission of sins should be preached.
You know.
In them to all nations.
He says to us, as we are hearing, he said, it has been written, and I said it while I was with you, that I will die. Though you didn't understand it, and I will resurrect. and the gospel I give unto you must be preached. The gospel of repentance must be preached. There's no one that cannot get repentance from the Lord. If you come to the understanding of the will of God and say, God, I don't know, you don't want me to do this. I know somebody will say, what are they talking about? We are talking about the coming back of our Lord Jesus Christ. It will come with judgment. And the judgment is about what you do here and now, what I do. If you do evil, the judgment will come on the evil. If I do good, the judgment will come over the evil. I mean the good. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That is what he says we should go and talk about. So what does he say for that, sir?
And should be preached.
And to be preached.
In his name.
In the name of God.
To all nations.
To all the nations of the world.
Beginning at Jerusalem.
From Jerusalem to all the land of the world.
And you are witness of these things.
Thank God for pandemic a bit too, sir. Thank God for pandemic. Because I can say this, that gospel travel more than before during this time of pandemic.
Yeah, by Zoom.
By Zoom, people listen to the word of God. Many came to the repentance. If that is what God, why God wants to extend it, let it be. That evil will cease in our land. Hallelujah.
Amen.
People cannot walk like it was before. Even when I came to this country, people cannot walk. Like then, there are evil increasing every day. In the country where I came from, in Africa, evil is increasing, even not even every day, every minute. And that is what God is coming, because the evil is about somebody beside you. It's about somebody you don't like. To the point that some people, they don't care what they want to do against their child, their own child. Giving battle. They can use their own children for ritual, wife for ritual, wife who use husband for ritual. Everything is increasing every day. They are against him in the land. Even gay priests, they don't want people to talk about this even now. Whereas, it is better we talk about it, whatever anybody want to do. During the time of Jesus Christ, some were in prison, some were beheaded, were killed. It doesn't matter, it's only about you. Everybody will die. It doesn't matter the way somebody dies. But the assignment that God has given somebody like me is to go and talk about coming back of our Lord Jesus Christ, that the evil in the land, we check on everyone. Fire is coming, hell is coming. Because God gave law about it, he created man and woman to marry to one another. Say that is what he wanted, not man to marry man, not woman to marry woman. Hallelujah. Amen. He's making God unhappy. Hallelujah. Amen. So what does the book of 2 Timothy chapter 3 from verse 1 says? Quickly, sir.
But know this. That in the last day, perilous times will come.
Perilous times that we are in shall surely come.
For men will be loving of themselves.
Men! When you hear men, he's talking about everyone, both man and woman, young and old, will be lovers of themselves. Not even things of God anymore. Not loving their friends anymore. Loving their neighbors anymore. It will be all about you. You want to become this. You want to become this. I want to be known. I want my fame alone. I don't want to hear another person say, alone. It's me. And God said, if you don't love your fellow brethren, you will raise evil against that person. Somebody you don't like, you raise evil against him or her. If you don't like your wife, you take evil against her. Even while you sit together in the same bed, you don't like your children, you want them to die. Evil to just come upon them. These are the things God said is coming to shake by the time it comes.
For men,
I love Jesus Christ, coming, sir. The way he explained it, we cannot go there today. In the book of life, he said, whatever you don't want anyone to do unto you, don't do to somebody else. If you don't want anyone to kill you, why do you want to kill somebody? You don't want somebody to destroy your handwork. Why must you destroy somebody's handwork? Why must you disturb and destroy the handwork of God? That person is the handwork of God. The earth that we are in belongs to God. He was the one who created it. That's your house you bought. You know how painful it is when somebody comes to take over your house. When somebody comes to overthrow you out of the government seat that you are in. You know how painful it is. How much more where you want to up to you, you want to overthrow God from, you know, discharging his law and order. Sir, what does he say for that, sir? Evil is increasing every day in our land, and Lord, God said he doesn't want it. Lord, as you are going to the year 2021, begin to check your mind, your heart. Judgment will come. Is it coming? Is it going to roll over, roll over, roll over? We don't know when it will start. God said, I am still in charge.
Lovers of money.
If you can pray in our heart of heart for forgiveness of sins all over the land, all over the world, nations of the world, that Lord, we have sinned against you. Forgive us. Maybe there can be people, if you are one of those that you say, devil is the one that is bringing pandemic, it's a great bitter lie. It is not. God says it's not. Go and ask from God more. If you are a preacher, or you are, you know, it doesn't matter your position, but I mean bishop, go and ask God more. Go closely to God. Say, God, is it true that you are the one in charge? I know God will never lie. Because everything I've said about this pandemic thing, where we, you know, COVID-19 pandemic, everything has been coming to pass. You see, he said he will still work on the on everything that remains. So what does he say, sir?
Lovers of money.
Lovers of money.
Boasters.
Boasters.
Proud.
Proud people.
Blasphemers.
Blasphemers.
Disobedient.
Disobedience.
To parents.
Oh, to parents, to God, to every man, to even the Lord of the land.
Unthankful.
Unthankful.
Unholy.
Unholy.
Unloving.
Unloving.
Unforgiving.
Unforgiving.
Slanderers.
Oh my God, slanderers.
Without self-control.
Without self-control.
Brutal.
Brutal.
Dispersers.
Many are so brutal, they can do anything and not do anything.
Dispersers of the presence of good.
Yes.
Traitors.
Traitors.
Headstrong.
Evil is in the land. Evil is increasing day by day as we are hearing every day. Nothing good anymore. We have few good people, few good friends, few good husband and wife, few pastors and few prophets and apostles, few presidents, few prime ministers, few good senators all over the land. We have few children, good children, even now. In every corridors, good, you know, few good colleagues. Evil is increasing in the land. You don't know who you can trust anymore in nations of the world. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I was just discussing with the man of God. We are coming in the country where I come from, Nigeria. As of today, if you want to go, if you want to embark on a journey, you are not sure if you come back. Just say you think you want to go back, you want to have a journey of 3 hours, come back home. You are not sure if you go and come back home. For crying aloud. In a peaceful place where God created you and I, we have raised evil every day against one another. And you think God will be looking. Judgment is coming. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He said a lot of things in that place. Sir, what does he say in verse 15 of that place? Quickly. 16. Verse 15.
15.
To the last.
And that from childhood.
From childhood.
You have known the holy scriptures.
You have known the holy scriptures.
Which are able to make you wise.
Which are able to make you wise.
For salvation.
There is no one who doesn't know good things. For peace to reign. You know what you don't want people to do to you. Which means you have a conscience to do good. But what does he say to them? They're not good from the right on. But what happened to them?
To make you wise.
To make you wise.
For salvation through faith.
For salvation through faith in the Lord, in the word of God.
Which is in Christ Jesus.
In Christ Jesus.
All scriptures
in you know all we know about UK, where we are, British land. Hey, it's a place of God. Even when I was looking at when they were doing the coronation of our queen mother, Elizabeth, yeah. Great mommy, I remember that it was by anointing of the Spirit of God. The old land was filled with the power of God. They recognized God. They love God. Hallelujah. Amen. But the loving of God today is about facial things. It's about charitable things alone. It is not about what God really wanted for the heart of people. Hallelujah. Amen. How can you say you are a gay man and you are doing charitable things and you think God will accept it? No, he will not accept it. The Bible says some, he will accept their offering, but he will not accept them. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That is what God is saying. I am not an engineer. I am a prophet of God. Say, go and tell my people this. Hallelujah. There is increase in evil day by day in our lands all over the world.
All scriptures is given by inspiration of God.
All scriptures were given by the inspiration of God.
And is profitable for doctrine.
And it is profitable to the doctrine of God.
For reproof.
To reproof us.
For correction.
To correct us.
For instruction in righteousness.
To give an instruction.
That the man of God may be complete.
That you, man of God, you might be complete. That you, man of God, you might be complete.
Truly equipped for every good work.
People of God, for you to be equipped for a good work, that is why you have these scriptures, for us to have a good work. Hallelujah.
Amen.
When you have your manual and you don't follow the manual, you will miss the interpretation of what you are trying to put together. A pilot, you know what you believe in to fly in the air. Hallelujah.
Amen.
A medical doctor, you know what you believe in to treat people in the hospital. Hallelujah.
Amen.
When somebody says, I have headache, I don't think you want to go to the engineer. You want to go to the hospital. The same thing when we are talking about holiness. We are talking about God. It is for the godly people to talk about it. God says he's not happy about what is happening in the world. If you don't believe in God, I believe in him. If you don't know him, I know him. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So go and read the rest. Sir, Revelation chapter. No, let's go to Matthew chapter 4. What does he say? From verse 5 to 23, if you can get there. Matthew chapter 4.
All right.
We're talking about what God is saying at this time. Evil in the land is increasing every day. And evil is about immoral. That we then have increasing every day. Immoral things. It's happening every day. Nakedness in our street, day by day. Doesn't matter anymore. Hallelujah.
Amen.
What does she say, sir?
Then the devil took him up into the
city. Then the devil took Jesus to a high place.
Set him on the pinnacle of the temple.
High places is where people are going every day. Where they love to enjoy the world. Worldly things alone. Where they plan evil. High places. Where you could see the whole world. You want to be an authority to see what is happening all over the world. To be in charge for evil to increase. A day of judgment, we not know who you are, why you are on the earth here. Either you are a president, you are a queen, you are a businessman, you are the most richest person in the earth. That is not what God wants to see that today. He wants to see how well you have done the good work. What does he say, sir?
I said to him, if you are the son of God,
if you are the son of God,
throw yourself down. For
it is written,
he shall give his angels charge over you.
Yes.
And in their hands,
yes,
they shall bear you up.
Yes.
Lest you dash your foot against a stone.
Yes.
Jesus said to him, it is written.
It is written.
You shall not tempt the Lord
you
your God.
You shall not tempt your Lord your God.
Again, the devil.
That is what we have in our land today. Even so many people, they want to carry, their regalians, their garment, that position. Hey, I am a son of God. I am a servant of God. I like to know my name. Oh, some people, if you call them brother, you are in trouble. Why are you calling me brother? They just want to carry title on their heads. Devil wanted to stage such as to that level where he can, you know, he can get hold of him and throw him down. But what does the Lord say to him?
And again, the devil took him up on an exceedingly high mountain.
Oh, yes.
And showed him all the kingdoms of the world.
He showed him every kingdom, the beauty of the world, of the glory of the world.
And he said to him,
all
this thing I will give you.
I will give all this
to you. If you fall down.
If you fall down.
And worship me.
And worship me.
Then Jesus said to him.
He said to him.
Away with me.
Go away from me.
Away with you.
Yes.
Satan. For
it is written.
You shall worship the Lord your God.
You shall worship your Lord your God. Him alone. You shall bow your head to.
Then the devil left him.
One of the evils in the land today is that people are just bowing their heads to all gods in the land. Their positions, immorals, they don't want to change their heart. And that is why God is not happy, that is not happy against what is happening in the land. Too late, God is not happy. God is not happy. Because he's talking, he has spoken about what will happen next year now. The one he has spoken this year, we see them happening. Battling our economy, battling us. You know, we are just we are covering our face to work now. You cannot
No breath.
Those who want to celebrate Christmas, we know how beautiful our Christmas was this year. God was the one in charge. And we are not listening. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We are not listening. I saw somebody yesterday, he overdrank himself. And he was easing himself in the same living room. He thought he was in the toilet. Hallelujah. Mm-hmm. And you overdrug yourself, you eat drugs. And after you do that, you begin to impart it. You are no more yourself. God said he doesn't want it. So that we can have peace in his heart. By the time he will call, because he doesn't want to destroy anyone. He wants us to change.
Just repent.
Just to repent. Say, I'm not going to do this again. But if you don't repent, a day of judgment, by the grace of God, I pray that I won't be a fire. You cannot come and drag me to fire. And I cannot come and drag you to the heavenly kingdom if I'm there. If I am in fire and you are in the kingdom of God, you cannot bring me out of fire. It's vice versa. So let us walk towards where we want to adjoin our last day, that day. Sir, what does he say quickly, sir?
Then the devil left him.
He left him.
And behold, angels came and ministered to him.
Yes.
Jesus. Then now, when Jesus
had... Sir, let's go to 20 and see what he said for verse 20.
Verse 20.
Yes.
They immediately left their nets.
Yes.
And followed him.
And followed him.
Going on from there, he saw two other brothers, James, the son of Zebedee,
yes,
and John, his brother,
uh-huh,
in the boat with Zebedee,
yes,
their father,
yes,
mending their net,
he called them,
and immediately
they left the boat,
and their father,
and followed him.
And Jesus went.
If you want to follow Jesus Christ, there are so many things you need to drop. I need to drop. Hallelujah. Amen. And you will continue to drop one thing every day of your life till Jesus come. Those are the people he loves. If you are in the classroom, you know, and you want your teacher to love you, you must make sure you gradually, you know, becoming who he wants you to become. Yesterday, you score 45. Oh, so it's not good enough. Tomorrow you have 50. So yeah, you are coming up. Oh, you are a good boy, you're a good somebody. But next tomorrow you got 55. Oh, you are coming up. By the time you get 80, that's my son. That's my, you know, whatever I want to call you. That is the same way Jesus Christ wants us to walk with him. You might not be in 90%, you know, at a go, but day by day you'll be dropping something for the sake of the Lord. They drop something to follow him. God wants to drop something to follow him. Because there are evils in the land. He wants you to drop that evil mind that you carry about. If you don't kill somebody today, you will not sleep. You want to be killing every day. He wants to be dropping them. That fornication dropping, you know, what is meant to chase another person's wife. Or suppose somebody's husband is the one you like. You don't like your own husband. And that person's husband. You don't love your own job, but you are hiring somebody's job in the same office. You want him to be sacked for you to get there, and you be saying so many things against that person. You don't, oh my God, you don't just like anything about yourself, but somebody's. It's an evil. It's an evil. If you don't change from it, by the time I come, judgment will follow. What does it say in the book of Revelation? Chapter 22.
Behold! I am coming quickly.
I am coming quickly.
Blessed is he who keeps the words of the prophecy of this book.
The quickly of our Lord Jesus Christ, my even when you have left this world. Many had even left. Because this world has gone to us since about 2,000 years ago. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And he has not come yet. And many has gone. Yours might be tomorrow, mine might be even tonight. But what he said to us that he's coming quickly. Your quickly will be when, you know, you leave this place. But what does he say will happen to them, sir?
Now. I just saw and heard these things. And when I heard and saw.
When I saw.
I fell down.
Yeah, I fell down.
To worship before the feet of the angel who showed me these things.
Yes.
Then he said to me.
He said to me.
See that you do not do that.
Don't do that.
For I am your fellow servant.
I am your fellow
and
servant.
And of your brethren, the prophets.
You know.
And of those who keep the words of this book, worship God.
Hallelujah.
And he said to him.
He said to him.
Do not seal the words of the prophets of this book.
Mm.
For the time is at hand.
The time is now coming.
So who is unjust? Let him be unjust.
When still. You are unjust, check yourself not to be unjust forever. If you are unjust, please check yourself. Because a time we call us, and I had this thing, don't let it be your portion.
Who is fitly, let him be fitly.
When you are fitly, please check yourself. Don't be fit,
He who is righteous.
When you are righteous, be righteous.
He who is holy.
When you are holy,
let him be holy still.
Be holy still. Don't change your mind, though.
And behold, I'm coming
quickly. I'm coming quickly.
And my reward is with me.
He said to us, if you want to be fit, continue. After you hear this word, what are they talking about? Say, a day will come that we know another path for anyone to tread, to go by. Than the path of judgment. Nobody will come that day to help anyone. Even Jesus Christ will no more appeal for anyone. It is now that he's still pleading for you and I that is watching. For the whole world, he's still pleading for your sin that you are committing now. But that day, nobody will plead for you and I anymore. It will be judgment. It is now we can listen so that God can be happy.
And behold, I'm coming quickly.
I'm coming quickly.
And my reward is with me.
And my reward is with
to
me.
To give to everyone.
To give to everyone.
According to their works. I am the Alpha.
I am the Alpha.
And the Omega.
And the Omega.
The beginning.
The beginning.
And the end.
And the end.
The first.
He's the leader of all the leaders. The king of all the kings.
Blessed are
those. He's the president of all the presidents. That day we shall all know.
Blessed are those who do his commandments.
God bless you, sir. Blessed are those that obey the commandment of the Lord here on earth.
They may have the
right, that they may have the right place
the
with
tree
him.
Of life and may enter on the last days into the city.
God bless you, sir.
Amen.
The evil is increasing in the land. We can see with our faces, our eyes now. God is saying to us, go and take my people. Whoever have ears, let them have the ears and obey what he wanted. You are not meant to kill that man. You are not meant to destroy that marriage. You are not meant to destroy your brother. You are not meant to destroy your brother, your wife, your husband. It doesn't matter how close that person might be to you. He doesn't want to kill them, to put sorrow into their heart, into their family. Because a day of judgment will strike every one of us. If you have not given your life to the word of God that you are hearing today, the word that Jesus Christ brought to us, it is now you can do like Zacchaeus did. That yes, I release everything for your sake, O Lord. I have no more to do evil. And Jesus will forgive you. He will wipe away your tears. He will forgive you. How do they know that Jesus forgives? Near he speak to his people. If he can speak to you tonight in your dream, say, trust Jesus Christ. He will come to you. He will die with you as he did unto Zacchaeus. If Jesus tarries, by the power in the name of Jesus Christ, we shall appear the same time next week.
Amen.
From me now, from the man of God. God bless you.
Amen.
You will enjoy the year 2021 that is coming.
Amen.
By the power in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
But remember, evil must cease in our land.
Amen.
Evil is increasing every day. Jesus Christ said, I don't want evil. God bless you.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Hello viewers, God bless you. My name is Prophet Stephen Larry Wajolotu from International Christian Association. Please join me on every Thursday between 2 p.m. and 3 p.m. on Faith Television, Channel Sky 589. You know, the Lord is sending us to this generation to speak about the coming back of our Lord Jesus Christ. These messages have been changing life, bringing people closer to God, bring understanding to the heart of people. Part of this program, and I believe you shall be blessed.
All your inheritance is in this hand.
Wonder.